我非常感谢美国总统拜登、美国的政府、国会，还有世界各国对台海和平稳定坚定的支持。我在520就职演说当中也提到，台海的和平稳定是全球安全繁荣的必要元素。任何一个国家在台海伸波，影响区域的稳定，都不会为国际社会所接受。所以我也呼吁中国来跟台湾共同承担起区域稳定的重责大任。我非常期待跟中国透过交流合作，增进彼此的了解、理解、谅解、和解，创造互利互惠，迈向和平共荣的立场。
We elevated the Quad together with Japan, India, and Australia to advance free, open, secure, and prosperous Indo-Pacific. We're standing up for peace and stability across the Taiwan Straits. I have always been willing to use force when required to protect our nation, our allies, our core interests. When anyone targets American troops, we will deliver justice to them.
好，各位媒体朋友，大家早。今天是民进党举行第21届党代表以及地方党职的选举。我回到台南，善尽党员的责任，投下宝贵的一票。我要敬请全国的党员同志，今天也要踊跃投票，选出优秀的人才，为国家承担责任。好，谢谢大家。是，我非常感谢美国总统拜登、美国的政府、国会，还有世界各国对台海和平稳定坚定的支持。我在520就职演说当中也提到，台海的和平稳定是全球安全繁荣的必要元素。任何一个国家在台海伸波，影响区域的稳定，都不会为国际社会所接受。所以我也呼吁中国来跟台湾共同承担起区域稳定的重责大任。我非常期待跟中国透过交流合作，增进彼此的了解、理解、谅解、和解，创造互利互惠，迈向和平共荣的立场。是，台湾的民主得来不易，是许许多多人牺牲奉献的结果。代表民主象征的国会，更应该站在第一线，守护民主。在意识上，应该要尊重程序正义，不可违法表决，更要守护民众的权益。另外呢，在这个整个修法的过程中，来自全国各地自动自发公民团体理性发声，青年展现力量，这个也是台湾民主的价值。身为总统，有责任肯定在立法院每一个遵守议事程序的委员，也有责任感谢每一个国人勇敢地站出来守护民主的每一个人。我非常希望国内能够团结，特别是面对局势、区域局势的变化，也面对国际社会对台湾支持的时候，国人更应该要团结。也只有团结，我们才能够克服种种的困难，一直挺进。好，谢谢大家。是，台湾的文化工作者到中国被迫政治表态，这不是第一次，也应该不会是最后一次。那每一次台湾的文化工作者曾在他人的屋檐下承受压力，我都感到非常的不舍。但是我也请国人能够了解， 在别人的屋檐下，我们的文化工作者讲什么内容固然是一回事，但更重要的是他们内心想的是什么，我们应该给予谅解了，好，给予体谅。那我们也会继续努力，好，守护国家，让台湾继续进步，让文化工作者能够有更好的发展。好，谢谢大家，谢谢。
On the other side of the world, in the Indo-Pacific, we deepened our alliances. We've created new ones, like AUKUS, our new strategic partnership with Australia and the United Kingdom, or the trilateral cooperation we forged with Japan and the Republic of Korea that no one thought was possible. Two of our allies cooperating on strategic defense thanks to our leadership.We've begun the new trilateral partnership with Japan and the Philippines as well. We elevated the Quad together with Japan, India, and Australia to advance free, open, secure, and prosperous Indo-Pacific. We're standing up for peace and stability across the Taiwan Straits. We're dependent on our strategic partnership with Vietnam. I wonder if the classes of 74 here today could have imagined that they were sittingwhere you were at the same time and during Vietnam. The upshot of all this, across vastly different regions and very different challenges, our women and men in uniform are hard at work, strengthening our alliances, because no country has allies like ours, investing in deterrence, so anyone who thinks they can threaten us thinks again, defending our values by standing up to tyrants and safeguarding the peace,by protecting freedom and openness. Thanks to the U.S. Armed Forces, we're doing what only America can do. As the indispensable nation, the world's only superpower, and the leading democracy in the world. Never forget, America is the strongest when we lead not only by our example of our power, but by the power of our example. You can clap for that.I want to mention one additional way we've made progress. Every member of our armed forces must always be safe and respected in the ranks. For the first time in nearly a decade, rates of sexual assault and sexual harassment have gone down across the active duty forces. It's long past time to end the scourge of sexual violence in the military. Once and for all, and we can do this. Cadets,Make no mistake, there remains a hard power world. You can't draw any other conclusion when powerful nations try to coerce their neighbors or terrorists attempt evil plots. That's why I'm making historic investments in our military, overhauling our defense industrial base. For decades, America has had the most powerful military in the world. And that happens because we choose to make it happen.I have always been willing to use force when required to protect our nation, our allies, our core interests. When anyone targets American troops, we will deliver justice to them. That happened earlier this year when three heroic members of the U.S. Army Reserve were killed in an unmanned drone attack in northeast Jordan. In response, we launched dozens of successful airstrikes against Iran-backed militants, and we'll never forget.To honor the memory of those warriors who gave their lives in the fight against terrorism. Cadets, West Point has made you leaders of character. In minutes, you'll be United States Army officers. In time, some of you will serve in powerful roles at headquarters, the Pentagon, even in the White House, to confront challenges a previous generation of soldiers couldn't imagine. When that happens,Hold fast to your values you learned here at West Point. Duty, honor, country. Hold fast to your honor code, which says, quote, we will not lie, steal or cheat, nor tolerate those who do, end of quote. And above all, hold fast to your oath. On your very first day at West Point, you raised your right hands and took an oath, not to a political party,not to a president, but to the Constitution of the United States of America, against all enemies, foreign and domestic.